One of the big challenges of teaching science in general is you have really cool and exciting things that you want to talk about, and you're stuck in a classroom and you're using the tools of science. And those tools of science are things like equations and math and dry sorts of things. So how do you bring the excitement of understanding how a tiger deals with the temperature environment it's in? It lives in a hot place. How does it maintain its body temperature without it being a chalkboard filled with math equations? Because that's a big leap for someone. They would much rather watch David Attenborough talking about a tiger with the beautiful pictures than sitting in my class. And one way you can do that is through a group activity. There's usually in my class 40 to 50 students, so there's 5 or 6 or 7 groups. So there's 7 iterations of peer teaching, where they're teaching using the equations how this interaction works. And so over one classroom period, they get the dry me giving them everything, the group activity of working together to make it work out so that they're happy to present it, and then they get to teach to each other 7 times on the receiving and the giving end. And at the end of it, sort of comprehension in that between the original dry lecture and the end point of doing that for semesters, my exam questions and the way I evaluate it, it's gone up by about 50%. So it works. People remember a lot more when they're engaged in those processes through the class period than by just having a traditional lecture. And so when I go through the process of here's how we're going to describe how energy is exchanged between that tiger's body and the environment, we're going to describe it with an equation. And I go through what those equations are and all the different ways that energy can be transferred between the tiger and its environment. And then I divide them into groups. And they're what they are told to do in that group is now you need to design an organism and an environment. So your environment can be someplace very cold where this organism has to maintain its temperature in spite of that cold environment. And you need to build that organism. It can be anything. It can be from Star Wars. I really don't care. All you have to make it do is have some physiological or anatomical characteristic that is affecting how it interacts with that environment. And then I want you to take those equations and attach it to your organism. So you're going to say, this organism has white fur because that helps it maintain its temperature balance in this way in this equation. So they can take a piece out of that equation and say, okay, this is why that organism is that color, or this is why this organism has this physiological characteristic. And I give them 5 or 10 minutes to sort of design that, and then they come up and they draw the organism on the board and go through the process of describing it in terms of the equations to the other class.